Imagine dying of laughter. Well, this is something that has become synonymous with Kuru disease. However, this is a misconception. Laughing death is only a nickname given to Kuru disease, considering that uncontrollable laughter is one of its many symptoms. Yes, it is true, while extremely, extremely rare, you can die from laughter, and it will not be because of Kuru. Laughing death does not really explain the full picture of Kuru disease, due to it being a fatal neurodegenerative disease. What does that mean? Well, that basically means your brain cells lose their function gradually, which ultimately leads to a fatal outcome. In this video, we will attempt to demystify this rare disease and improve our understanding of the various concepts associated with Kuru disease.
The first case of Kuru came to the attention of scientists in 1957, and roughly 1,000 deaths were observed from 1957 to 1961. With time, the number of deaths per year has declined to approximately 2 mortalities in the last 5 years. Given its causes, Kuru is most prevalent among the 4 people of the eastern highlands of Papua New Guinea, where people consumed dead corpses of their relatives as a sign of respect. Within this region, Kuru is known to be most prevalent in the villages, where the fatality rate is identified to be 3.5% of 12,004 people. While the incidence of the disease is mainly limited to the Four region, the sex and age distribution proved remarkable. Kuru is known to have a wide distribution with respect to age. However, 60% of the Kuru cases are observed in adult females, 2 in adult males, and the remainder in children and adolescents of both sexes. The youngest case of Kuru was seen in a 4-year-old child, and the oldest was seen in an individual age over 60 years old.
Now let's flip the page and talk about the disease symptoms. The brain is responsible for all sorts of functions throughout your body. Therefore, those who have Kuru disease experience loss of functioning throughout their body due to brain degeneration. The symptoms that patients with Kuru disease experience are the following: trouble with walking and coordination, slurred speech, having a hard time swallowing, and uncontrollable spouts of laughter. As the condition worsens, patients may experience dementia, and due to trouble swallowing, malnutrition and starvation frequently occurs. Typically toward the final stages of the disease, patients may succumb due to lung infection, aka pneumonia, or to causes linked with malnutrition. As of today, it is considered a fatal disease, which on average may take up to 12 months from the first sign of symptoms to progress to the final stage.
So how does all this occur? Well, Kuru is considered a prion disease. This means that abnormal proteins called prions deposit in the nervous system and damage it. This can occur due to genetic mutations to the PRNP gene that codes for the protein PRPC, resulting in abnormal folding. When this occurs, the cell has several options. One option is to try and increase the cell's folding capacity of proteins through several mechanisms. Another option is to send misfolded proteins to a local garbage dump. Yes, it exists in cells. It is called a proteasome. More about that in another video. If this does not restore the balance, the cell has one last option: to engage an unfolded protein response that ultimately may cause the cell to die. That's right. Cells under certain circumstances may choose to undergo these programmed ways of destroying themselves if no other options work out. Another aspect that may be important to mention is that while the cells try to find ways of responding to these misfolded proteins, they are less likely to respond well to foreign threats, like infections. This is because they simply cannot deal with multiple things at a time. So how do people contract this devastating disease? The answer is similar to other prion diseases, as in that it is contracted when people eat meat that is not well preserved. In the case of Kuru, it is specifically associated with human cannibalism. The thing with prions is that they have a cascade effect whereby they infect other normal proteins and also cause them to misfold. This is why once a person is infected, the disease continues to degrade the nervous system, resulting in the symptoms discussed earlier. Unfortunately, these prions are super resistant to degradation, which is why the disease progression is not stoppable. Most patients are provided medications to manage their symptoms, such as painkillers. Some patients are also given antidepressants, as it is common to develop depression within a terminal disease.
Ultimately, the difficulty curing Kuru disease is associated with the fact that it is a prion disease. Hopefully, further research into prion diseases can lead to methods of correcting protein aggregates in the near future. We hope that now you know more about the pathophysiology of Kuru disease, its symptoms, and prevalence worldwide. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more Demystifying Medicine content.